Yeah, so a friend of mine had his mailbox knocked over. He asked me to make him just a post to put his new mailbox up on. So I've got this 7 foot cedar post I cut a while back, and I haven't used the Alaska mail in a while, so I thought I'd get it out and try to make him one with a couple of smooth flat sides. We'll see how it comes out. He's not asking for much. So here's the Alaska sawmill. They come in different lengths. I've got this one mounted to an Echo timber woof. It came with a 20-inch bar, which is the maximum I think recommended. I put a 24-inch bar on it, which I know you're technically not supposed to do that, but with a sawmill, you need a longer bar just to get it to fit. That doesn't mean you can make a cut that long, as you can see. You're losing about 3, probably 4 inches of the bar, so you're still down to 20 inches. So I think as far as power is concerned, it's just fine. But I'm not an engineer, but with this soft cedar wood, I don't think it's an issue. I've never done oak, although I intend to pretty soon. Haven't started the timber woof in several months, so we'll see how she fires up. Too bad. We'll let it warm up for a few minutes. Okay, so that didn't go so well. It'll go in like that, and the mailbox will go on top of here. It'll be kind of rustic with a live edge, and I'll probably whack this off back here somewhere. Go ahead and chisel this out. Might have been quicker just to make all the cuts with a circular saw. But I'm never one to do things the easy way. Hurt. I think that'll work. Cut this thing off somewhere here. Yeah, so I'm just going to plane this off with that hand planer to get it down to the natural red color, so it'll all be uniform. And we'll put a coat of, I'm thinking we'll just put a coat of Thompson's weather seal. I got a can of that. We'll see how it does. It'll probably gray real quick anyway. Yeah, so I'm just making a second board to go across here to make this wide enough to hold the mailbox. So, just need to cut it to length. And 18.
Right.